Good morning, everybody. Can you guys believe that most of you should be finished school right now? This is crazy. This is our last Sunday of June, and you guys are heading into summer holidays. I hope that you guys are gonna just have an amazing summer. And I'm so looking forward to seeing some of you at VBS in the end of July. So we are gonna head for one last time to our memory verse for this month, which is 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 4 to 7. So let's say this together. Love is patient, love is kind. It's not jealous anytime. It's not proud, it's not rude. Love forgives and speaks the truth. Love protects, it does not brag, it doesn't easily get mad. Love is hopeful and it trusts. When we love, we never give up. Love will never fail. Good job, everybody. So let's head to our song and let's worship our God. He deserves our praise, and I'll see you back here in a minute.
Love is kind, it's not jealous anytime.
It's not proud and it's not rude. Love forgives and speaks the truth.
Oh, yeah, love will never fail. Oh, yeah, love will never fail.
Love protects, it does not break. It doesn't easily get mad. Love is hopeful and it trusts. When we love, we never give up.
Never.
I like to think about the goodness of the Lord. He gives me everything I need and so much more. So I just want to lift my hands and say that I love him. I just want to lift my heart in praise. And I want to be faithful. I want to be faithful. I want to remember everything that the Lord has done. I want to be thankful. I want to be grateful. I want to be, I want to be, I want to be. I like to think about the goodness of the Lord. He gives me everything I need and so much more. So I just want to lift my hands and say that I love him. I just want to lift my heart in praise. And I want to be thankful. I want to be grateful. I want to remember everything that the Lord has done. I want to be thankful. I want to be grateful. I want to be, I want to be, I want to be thankful. I want to be grateful. I want to remember everything that the Lord has done. I want to be thankful. I want to be grateful. I want to be, 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 I want to be.
Welcome back, you guys. I hope you gave God all of the worship that he deserves this morning, got off your couches and gave him praise. So today we are going to talk about another part of who God is. We've been focusing the last few weeks on Holy Spirit, but we know that our God is three in one. He is the Father, he is the Son, and he is the Holy Spirit. And so today we are going to be learning about God as our Father and what that means to us. So let's head to our lesson and I will see you in a minute.
Do you have a brother or sister? Okay, do you have more than one brother or sister? Do you have more than two brothers or sisters? Wow, I'm not sure that people that could keep going and going and going, but what if I told you that I have a lot of brothers and sisters? I mean, a lot of siblings. More siblings than you could ever count. Do you want to know how many siblings that I have? Are you sure? Okay, well, it's more than 10. It's more than 20. More than 50, actually more than 100. It's more than 1,000, more than 2, 3, or 4,000. Actually, I have more than 1 million brothers and sisters. I know, it sounds crazy, but it's true, okay? Now, I know you're probably sitting there in your chair asking yourself, how in the world does a person have more than a million brothers and sisters? Like, where do they all live? Do they really have a really big car that they can fit all into? Or do they take a million tiny separate cars? What about their names? How do they know who is who? What happens when somebody calls out for, I don't know, Allie or Jenny or Bob? How many brothers are named Bob? Well, before you get too far ahead of yourself, I think you should understand how I have so many siblings. Do you want to know how I have so many brothers and sisters? Okay, it's actually quite simple. The easiest explanation I can give you as to how I have so many brothers and sisters is we all have the same dad. Yep, it's true. We all have the same dad. And can I be honest with you? He's a really good dad. I actually want to talk to you about my dad. Well, actually, I want to talk about your dad. Yes, your father. I want to talk to you today about how God is your father. Let's all say it together. God is my father. That was great. Now let's all say it again, okay? God is my Father. So we've been in this series, The God I Need to Know, and during it, we are breaking down and talking about different parts of God that you need to know. For the past couple weeks, we've been talking about the Holy Spirit and how awesome He truly is. But today, we're going to move along and start talking about God the Father. Now, what does this mean when I say that God is your dad?
Dad! Do you see my dad is here?
No, I'm kind of in the middle of this, though.
Oh.
Anyway, like I was saying, it's very important that you understand what I mean when I say that God is your father.
Dad!
No, your dad isn't here right now.
Aw, man.
Like I was saying, God is actually your heavenly father. That means that for those of you that have a dad here on earth... No, like I told you, your dad isn't here right now. So if you could go wait in the back while I finish this, that'd be awesome.
Fine.
I'm so sorry about that. Anyway, you need to know that God is your father, because it's very important that we know who our father really is.
Throughout the Bible, God is referred to as Father multiple times. In the Old Testament, prophets like Isaiah write, "Yet you, Lord, are our Father. We are the clay, you are the potter. We are all the work of your hand." From early on in the story of God's people, we see the Israelites referred to as His children. Time and time again, the people of Israel are rescued and brought back to their Father. And when we get to the New Testament, we see Jesus claim God as His Father and teach His followers to do the same. But what does this mean for us? How are we supposed to approach God here and now? Well, Jesus told us. As He was speaking to His disciples, He said to them, "Pray like this, Our Father." Wow! Jesus, the Son of God Himself, told us to call God Father. Even the Apostle Paul in Galatians 4:6 says, "Because you are His sons, God sent the Spirit of His Son into our hearts, the Spirit who calls out, Abba, Father." So Paul teaches us that it's the gift of the Holy Spirit living in us that calls out to God, Father. You and I, because of the finished work of Jesus on the cross, have been invited into the family of God. We are adopted as His sons and daughters, and we belong to His family.
Wow, Jesus was very clear about who His father was. Can I ask you a question? What thoughts come to your mind when I say the word father? I'm sure there are a lot of different answers out there because everyone has a different experience with their father. Some of you, when I say the word father, might have an awesome thought that looks like this. Some of you have thoughts that are really fun and exciting. When you think about your father, you can't help but let fun and awesome thoughts just fly across your head. But there are some of you here that, when I say father, it looks a little more like this. Some of you may not have very good thoughts about your father. The experience you have with your father here on earth may not be a very good one. There may not even be one at all. But the father I'm talking about today is not the same father that you have here on earth. The Father I'm talking about is so good. He's perfect. He's God. You see, God tells us that He is the creator of heaven and earth, the mighty God. But He also tells us that He is our Father. And can you imagine just how good of a Father He actually is? He knew you before anyone else did. He loved you before you ever took your first breath, before you ever took your first steps. He carried you in His big arms. He knew every hair on your head, every thought in your mind, and every dream in your heart. He protects you. He provides for you. And He promises to always be with you. He is always with you. He is a good father. You need to know that, yes, God gave you the parents that you have here on earth, and yes, they are your parents. But God is not only your heavenly father, but He is also your parents' heavenly father. Your parents are meant to model what kind of parents they are here on earth after God. They want to try and look like God, our Heavenly Father. Some of you here may have parents that do that, and that's awesome. And there may be a few of you in here that didn't have that kind of experience when it came to your Father here on earth. But it still doesn't change the truth. God is our Heavenly Father, and He is so good.
Growing up, I had an amazing family. We had so much fun together. And as I grew older, my amazing family became less and less amazing. My parents started fighting more. My siblings started fighting with each other and with my parents, and my amazing life at home slowly became terrible. My parents got divorced, and I had to make a really hard decision. Who do I live with? My mom or my dad? So I chose to live with my mom, and this really upset my dad. And there I was, a 13-year-old boy, living in a new city, living a new life, and all of it without my dad. And in my heart, I was lost and scared and confused. And during this time, I really leaned on God, and He shared something with me that I hold on even to this day. God said, "Caleb, you don't get to choose who your earthly dad is, but you do get to choose if you want me to be your father." At first, I was confused because I didn't understand the difference between a dad and a father. And in that moment, God showed me. He showed me how He would always be there for me, even when I felt alone. He reminded me that He will never leave me, no matter how hard life gets. He told me that He will always love me and forgive me when I make mistakes. He showed me that He would never get angry with me or yell at me for something that I did wrong. And in that moment, I decided that I wanted God to be my Father, who would guide me and love me and provide for me, watch over me, bring me joy, and never to leave me. And in that moment, I realized what the difference was in a dad and a father. You see, dads can make mistakes. They can forget things. They can be too busy to play with you. They can even leave us. But a father, God, He is someone who will never leave you. He will always make time for you. He will never forget about you. He always wants to hang out with you and will never miss an important moment in your life. But I started to think about some things that would be hard for God to do in my life on earth, like helping me through school and how to learn how to change a tire, or, I mean, just so many other things. So I asked God to give me multiple dads. Now, I know that sounds really weird, but what I was asking God for was for Him to place men in my life to help teach me things that I needed to learn, but I couldn't without my actual dad because we live so far apart. And He did. My mom got remarried, and my stepdad, he became one of my bestest friends. He helped me with school, and he taught me things like how to be kind and funny and compassionate. And God placed pastors at my church in my life for certain seasons to help me get through some pretty big ups and downs. And I even asked God to give me a best friend, and He did. And now my best friend's dad is someone who I consider to be one of my dads, even to this day. He showed me how to be wise with money and how to show unconditional love to people, even when they don't deserve it. When I got married, God gave me the best father-in-law, who has the same type of job as me, and we literally always have something to talk about. And He has shown me how to listen and how to connect with people. I can always talk to Him about whatever I'm going through, and He knows exactly what to say. And as time passed, my relationship with my real dad got better and better. You see, all those things that God had taught me through the men He placed in my life, I began to show them to my dad. I showed him kindness and compassion, unconditional love, and I forgave him for all the bad times that we had. Now, my dad and I are great friends. We hang out all the time, and God knew exactly what I needed. And the men He put in my life weren't by mistake. He knew exactly what I needed. And the best part about all of it is that in every single one of those moments in my life, God, my Father, was with me through every one of them, just like He promised.
Boys and girls, God is a perfect Father. The Bible shows us over and over and over again just how good He is to His children. If there were a blue ribbon or a first place trophy to give out for the Father of the universe, God would win it every single time. And from the beginning of time to this very day, God is still the best Father to His children. Now, I told you earlier that I have a lot of siblings. Do you know who these siblings are? You. It's you. We have the same dad up in heaven. And that means that we are brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ. We have the same dad who is loving and faithful and powerful.
Welcome back, everybody. So I am so thankful that God is the best Father ever. He loves us with unconditional love, which means His love does not depend on what we look like, how we act, what we're good at. He just loves you because He loves you, because you're you. So during that lesson, did you guys think about how you feel when you say the word Father? That's an interesting thing for us to think about and look at, because how we see our earthly Father can affect how we see our heavenly Father, God, right? And so we need to remember, yeah, things are not always easy in our earthly families, right? And our dads, our earthly dads, are not perfect. But we know that our heavenly Father is always there with us. He is perfect, and He will always love you with that unconditional love that each person really needs to feel. So also, we need to remember that our earthly fathers are just people, right? They're not God, and they're going to make mistakes. But they are hopefully working to grow closer to God and to treat you as God would want them to treat you, as your dad. So let's pray over just this understanding of knowing God as our Father. And also let's pray for our dads today. I know last week was Father's Day, but let's do that today, okay? So Jesus, we love You and we thank You for teaching us. And right now today, we're just learning about God as our Father. Our Father who takes care of us and protects us and loves us with an unconditional love. And I pray You would help every child to see You, Lord, as You are, a Father who loves us no matter what. And right now we pray for our earthly dads. We pray that You would just fill them up right now with the power of the Holy Spirit, that You would help them to walk in Your ways, Lord, that they would come to You for patience and wisdom and peace and everything they need, so that they can be the earthly dads that You've called them to be. So we thank You for our earthly fathers, and we thank You so much for being our heavenly Father who loves us every minute of every day and is there for us always. Thank You, and we just bless, I just bless every child in the name of Jesus right now, that they would come to know You as their heavenly Father. In Jesus' name, amen. Bye, guys. Have a fantastic week and enjoy your summer holidays.
Worthy of every song we could ever sing, worthy of all the praise we could ever bring, worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for You, oh, we live for You. Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever save. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for You. We live for You. Holy, there is no one like You. There is none beside. Show me who You are.
I will build my life upon. And I will build my life upon your love.